Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Today we're on one of our most highly anticipated trips. We're in London, and Rose is super excited for this one. We've been here a couple days, I ain't gonna lie to you, but we're gonna give you guys our top five things we love about London so far.
One, Harry Potter.
We haven't started yet. We're gonna tell you guys later, but we'll give you guys some must-dos when you visit London. At least things that we think you must do. Our London journey begins with a Harry Potter Warner Brothers studio tour, including a London walking tour. This tour was purchased off of Get Your Guide, and the activity provider was Walks UK. I'll drop the link down below for the exact tour we were on. We had an amazing tour guide who showed us all around downtown London, and even if you aren't a big Harry Potter fan, it was a good way to see most of the big sights downtown before being transported via bus to the studio. This is also a good alternative if the Warner Bros. Studio tours directly are all booked up. It was very expensive at £197 per person, but as you will learn, London is expensive. All right, guys, so the first thing that I love about London, it takes me back to last week when Rose had asked me when we were planning for this trip, what is the number one most thing you are excited about? And it's going to sound a little dumb to some people, but you got to remember, we've lived in Germany for about a year and a half now. So the thing that I said was just to be able to go anywhere and speak English to anyone. And we've been here a couple days now, and it's been great. You know, I could go anywhere, order anything, communicate, get whatever I need. And I love traveling, going new places, you know, talking to the people. But sometimes it's a little rough when you can't communicate. You don't get the exact thing you're looking for. And just being in a place that kind of reminds you of home a little bit makes you feel a little more comfortable. And especially for people traveling outside the U.S. for their first time, the U.K. would be a good place because you're going to feel more comfortable being able to speak English with people. After the walking tour, we hopped into this old British pub before being transported about an hour to hour 30 minutes, depending on traffic, to Warner Bros. Studio. And the duck croquettes were amazing.
Hey, tell them about the cider.
Delicious. I'm gonna live here. I'm never going back. I'm Drink. Sorry, but this is just my people. Cheers.
Tasty. Where are we?
Oh my god. We're in the home of the Wizarding Place. And this is my addition to be Hermione Granger in the upcoming Harry Potter TV show. Please hire me. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. This is the one, the only, the truly magnificent Great Hall. It is one of the largest and oldest sets built for the films. Effect I'm going to show you today. Now, this special effect will involve loud noises, flashing lights, water-based smoke machines, and pyrotechnics. If any, two, one, action.
Burbier sharing flight.
That's my spoon.
You know what? That tastes like something.
Deliciousness?
But I can't remember what. Very good. You know I'm a cupcake man. Very good. Cheers.
Thank you.
Not as good as the one at Universal.
I will say that, but very good.
So for tip two, also recommendation, Harry Potter, obviously. Even if you're not a Harry Potter fan, I mean, walking all over London, you see so many different Harry Potter references and Harry Potter shops and things like that. And honestly, it's just makes you feel the magic, the Harry Potter magic. But the actual Warner Brothers Studio Harry Potter world is incredible, right? And make sure that if you're going, you get transportation there because it is like an hour, hour and a half away. And then two, make sure that you have a lot of time because there is just so much to see. We were there in, 4 hours, and we felt like we were kind of rushed because halfway through it, you also have a cafe where, of course, you can get all your heart's desire of butterbeer ice cream, butterbeer cupcakes, and a butterbeer blondie. And just make sure that you have enough time because it is just magnificent. You have wands galore. The only thing that I didn't like about it is that they didn't really have any Dobby plushies, and I think they really missed out on that. Anyways, stay tuned for the next tip.
All right, guys, the next thing we love about London, after being here for a couple days, the food is fantastic. Now, you're going to see we did try your typical London breakfast or UK breakfast, whatever they call it. You're going to see that. And didn't like the beans on the toast. Everything else was all right with that.
First English breakfast was?
I love beans on toast. Specifically those beans. Everything else was made.
Same thing with the afternoon tea. We were not a fan of tea. We tried to enjoy it, but we couldn't. And the treats with that, it wasn't it. We did not like the afternoon tea. We tried, but other than that, all the other food was amazing. As you know, it's a cultural hub here, so you have food from all over the world. We tried Indian, pretty much everything you can imagine. We tried some of it. You're going to see all the videos, but the food was great. We ended it off tonight with a local steakhouse. I believe it was Flatiron. You're going to see those videos, and man, that was amazing. Great steak, cheap price, and we had the truffle mac and cheese, just amazing. But yeah, as you guys know, the food scene here is great. We went to the Camden Market, the Borough Market. Both of them had great food. We only tried a couple things from each, but they were all pretty good. And we saw so many different food halls, places to get multiple styles of food all around London. And it's just great. You could be here for months and probably still have tons and tons of things to try. So that's definitely something we loved and something you guys should check out. And if you've been to London, let me know what your favorite restaurant or place to eat was.
Hello. They're in your way. Pass them to me, chef. You put them on here. You put them on the front. Who's waiting? Ruffalo. There you are.
I love ice cream trucks. Okay. Looks weird, not gonna lie.
Again. No. Mushroom risotto with truffle oil. Pad Thai. Good.
So good.
Thank you.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up. I've been waiting forever to try these. Pretty good. I did not think they would be cold though. They're cold, which is interesting. You might love them. Pretty good, but they're cold. I like them a little more. All right, we got Rose here trying Nando's. I tried it a couple nights ago, didn't film it because she was asleep.
I was awake.
Or I don't know. But anyways, Nando's, delicious. She did try it.
Yeah.
But she got just the chicken. I got the chicken burger.
Yeah.
The smoky churrasco burger. Delicious. So she's going to try it and let you guys know what she thinks. But I think it was a solid 9 out of 10. Let me get this camera in here for a close-up.
Is this spinach?
Yes.
You ate it with onions?
No, I got mine without onions. Oh. And the peri-peri fries.
Shit, that's kind of hot. Oh, it smells good. Delicious. Oh my god. The chicken is so juicy. Are you still recording?
All right, guys.
Manchester United.
All right, guys. The next thing that we love about London is just the endless things that you can do here. You know, there's so many immersive experiences, plays, movies, things to see, things to eat, places to go. It's insane. We've been here about 5 days and we haven't even scratched the surface. And it just feels like you need to live here to fully experience everything.
What?
Anything.
Manchester else? United. I live here. Thank you. And remember to hire me for Hermione Granger for the Harry Potter TV show.
Thing we loved about London, well, not the last, but the last tip for this video, has got to be how kind the people were. You know, we live in Germany and there's all the stereotypes, you guys could think what you think about different places and how the people are. I won't tell you what to think. But everyone that we ran into here was kind, willing to help us. And, you know, just speaking the same language as us makes it easy for us to communicate what we need from them.
Where'd you get this?
Maybe people are kinder, but I also feel like in a touristy area, you're dealing with people all day. You're probably not going to be as happy to deal with people. So take that as you may. Everyone we ran into was super kind, and we really enjoyed that. London, definitely towards the top, if not the top of our list of places we've been. A couple of tips to leave you guys with for when you visit London. Make sure you choose a good place to stay. You know, I know everyone wants to stay in Soho or in that area. And that area is great, but you got to remember it's going to be way more expensive and you're going to get a lot less space. We're staying in Bankside.
This is how close we are to the Thames River. Let's go.
And there are a ton of things over here, you know, kind of an underrated spot. And the price we paid was cheaper than a lot of places in Soho. And we got a king size bed. Whereas in Soho, a lot of the places were full size beds.
That's the London Bridge.
Unless you were paying for like the suite. So we're here at the Native Bankside. In the suite on the top floor, king size bed, beautiful apartment, hotel, whatever you want to call it. And it even has a washer and dryer in the unit. So if you're here for a long time, perfect, everything you need. I'll show you guys a quick tour so you could actually see how much space we did have here. Definitely a great hotel, highly recommend it. The next tip I would give you is to make sure you take public transportation while you are here. It's a lot cheaper than taking Ubers everywhere, and you're not going to be able to walk everywhere. The tube was very easy to navigate once we did it one time. Highly recommend. I ain't going to tell you how to do it. You'll figure it out on your own. But it is great to know that the daily cap is around £8, no matter how many times you take the tube, as long as you use the same card. So keep that in mind. And everyone here bikes. There's those electric bikes all around. We didn't use them. I wish we did. But maybe you guys use them and let me know how it goes for you. Seems like a great way to get around. And last tip I can give you guys is immerse yourself in the experience while you're here. We went to a burlesque show or a cabaret. Was a little interesting. It was a weird one. I ain't gonna lie to you. We tried the English breakfast. We tried the tea time. We went to the museum. That was amazing. Highly recommend the museum. If there's one thing you definitely do, go to the British Museum. It's free and it was crazy to see. But also, we went to a play, Hadestown. The play was Hadestown. And it was a great play. It makes us want to watch more plays. So definitely when you're here, try to do some of the things that they do. See if you like them. We definitely had a great time. We really enjoyed London in this trip. It was our favorite trip we have been on. I lied to you a couple of minutes ago in the last video. We loved it. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you in the next video. If you made it this far, thank you. Please like and subscribe and leave a comment letting us know what you love about London or maybe what you dislike about it. We'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out!